Everybody knows this song. For our praise and worship this morning, we just want to honor God and tell him how great he is. If you believe it, put your hands together, stand on your feet, however you choose to worship this morning, and give God your best and just say, how great.
Thank you. going to ask, as we have one of the tremendous works of ministry in which we engage here, is our graduate recognition Sunday. And so I'm going to call on the leader of our graduate recognition Sunday, Sister Lynn Carr. Amen. Give God praise and glory for Sister Carr as she comes. Amen. To lead us in our efforts.
Aaron Matthew Brown Jr. Parents. Parents are Aaron and Monica Brown, brother Tillman Brown. He graduated from Avon High School, receiving his high school diploma. His honors and awards are National Honor Society member, cum laude, recognized by the Lorain County Alliance of Black School Educators for Academic Excellence. Aaron's plans for the future have not been finalized yet, but with God's guidance and prayers, he will follow the plan he has for him. Nathan Alexander Burns. Parents, James T. Burns and Tajay Jones Clancy. Siblings, James T. Burns II, Trinity Clancy. Grandmother, Geraldine Burns Woodard. He graduated from Benedictine High School, receiving his high school diploma. His honors and awards are cum laude, proficiency in awards in French, chemistry in chorus, senior recognition award for men's chorus, president of the Black Cultural Organization and Sunshine Club. Nathan plans to attend Cleveland State University in the fall to obtain his associate's, bachelor's, master's, and MBA majoring in business. When he obtains his degrees, Nathan will attend law school to study pre-law and become a corporate attorney. With God, Nathan's dreams and plans will come true through his hard work and faith in God. Zion Darby. Parents, James Smith Darby and Tommy Smith Darby. Siblings, Emily and Dallas Smith Darby. He graduated from Lakewood High School, receiving his high school diploma. In his honors and awards are that he was ranked top 50 basketball player in Ohio, scholar athlete, second team all conference, honor roll all 4 years, and Coach Bob Patton Award. Zion received a basketball scholarship to Fairmount State University, where he will be attending this summer, he left today, to obtain his bachelor degree in exercise science and master's in business administration. Malia Knuckles. Parents, Kevin and Marcy Knuckles. Brother, Kevin Knuckles. She graduated. She graduated from Cuyahoga Valley Christian Academy, receiving her high school diploma. Malia plans to attend Kent State University in the fall, majoring in economics and minoring in English. She eventually would like to become a corporate lawyer. Ethan Williams Taylor. Parents, Ron and Smith Pierce, Keith and Melissa Taylor. Siblings, Caden and Cameron Pierce, and Logan and Morgan Taylor. He graduated from Villa Angela St. Joseph High School, receiving his high school diploma. Ethan will be attending Tri-C, where he will be studying recording arts and technology. Alexis Walter. Parents, Chris and Alfie Walter. She graduated from Solon High School, receiving her high school diploma. Her honors and awards is that she is the Comet of the Semester and made merit roll. Alexis will be attending Central State University in Wilberforce, Ohio. For business administration with a concentration in entrepreneurship. Richard Carter White. Parents, Marva and Leonard White. Brother, LJ White. He graduated from Cleveland Heights High School, receiving his high school diploma. His honors and awards are Homebred Legends Award, Academic Scholarship from Ashland University. Richard will be attending Ashland University with an intended major in sports management and a minor in marketing. Richard has hopes of either becoming a sports agent or owning a sports franchise. Rachel Bediaco. Parents, Deacon Gabe and Deaconess Trina Bediaco. Siblings, Josh and Sarah Bediaco. She graduated from Kansas College, receiving her degree in Master's in Communication from Kansas College and Communication degree from Bowling State University. Her honors and awards, she's a member of Kappa Kappa Gamma's women's fraternity. Rachel graduated with her Master's in Communication and Leadership with a focus in organizational leadership. Rachel attributes her success and determination from the love and support she has received from her family and church family. While her path is still being shown to her, she is applying to jobs across several fields in Columbus, Chicago, San Diego, and many other booming cities. Rachel can't wait to share with her church family her journey and what God has revealed to her about her path.
Now we have Harper Jones. Parents are Herbert and Courtney Jones, and the sibling is Harriet Jones, Harlan Jones. Her education, Miami University, her English literature with a minor in social justice studies. Harper has accepted a position as a Spanish instructor at Fundamentals Academy. She plans to attend law school in Los Angeles, California in the fall of 2020. Her future aspirations include becoming an entertainment lawyer and eventually opening her own entertainment management firm in Los Angeles. We have Raymond J. Moore McCray, the parents. We have Raymond J. Moore McCray. Keep going. Okay. The parents are Desmond and Barbara McCray. The sibling is Mary, Gary, Alan, Jamila, and Jordan. The girlfriend is Kalia Fisher Grace. The college, Cleveland State University, and he has a degree in Bachelor of Business Administration. Raymond's future plans include becoming a franchise owner and continue his career in human resources. Okay, we have Sabrina Mora, Okay, Sabrina Mora, the parents are Brenda Gornis, it's her aunt, and her sibling is Alicia Mora, and the children is Jeremiah, Janiah, and Jasmine. She is Ultimate Medical Academy. She has an associate's degree in a medical administration assistant. Sabrina plans to seek her career as a medical assistant. We have Kayla Napoleon. Her parent, Camilla Napoleon. The sibling is Christian Napoleon. The college, she finished Kent State University. She's a degree at Associate of Arts, Bachelor's in Sports Administration with a business minor. Her artists are National Society of Leadership and Success, Sigma Alpha Phi Kent State Chapter. Kayla's plans for the future is to follow the path that the Lord has set before her. Okay, next we have Craig Price, Jr. Craig's parents are Craig and Danielle Price. The sibling is Nia Price. He got his degree from Rochester Institute of Technology. And he got his degree in Bachelor's of Science in Information. And Craig plans for the future to let God direct his path. We have Marcus Primes, Marcus A. Primes. The parents are Marcus and Kathy Primes. The sibling is Kayla Primes. The college, George Washington University. And he received a master's degree in systems engineering. Marcus is currently working as a system engineer at the Federal Aviation Administration in Washington, D.C. Marcus hopes to enter into a managerial training program at the FAA. Marcus also received his undergraduate degree from Purdue University in West Lafayette, Indiana. Okay, we have Jared Scott Simpson. Parents are Dole and Pamela Simpson. The siblings Bryson and Dole Jr. The college is Johnson C. Smith University. He got a Bachelor's of Arts, and Jared was cum laude. Jared plans include working in the field of real estate and becoming an entrepreneur, moving forth his own brand and utilizing his leadership skills. He also plans to obtain his MBA to further his entrepreneur studies and plot and launch his own startup company. Jared's ultimate dream is to start a nonprofit organization worldwide for youth and teens in the United States urban areas, in which he would call it Dreams Come True. Okay, Mikhail Monet Travis. Michelle. Parents are James and Tanya Travis. The sibling is Krista Victor Travis. And the children is Kaylin Lewis. The college is Ohio University. She received a Master's of Science in Nursing, Family Nurse Practitioner. Michelle has accepted a position as family nurse practitioner at University Hospital in the Department of Family Medicine and Community Health. She looks forward to using the skills and talents that God has blessed her with to care for many.
Amen. I'm going to allow the escorts and parents to have a seat. Thank y'all. Before I get started with my words of encouragement, I'm going to announce our Nancy Stewart Scholarship recipients. Malia Knuckles, and Richard White. We have a special scholarship from the Vera O. Bowie Circle, and I'm going to ask our president to come forward, and Pastor Davidson will choose one high school and one college for the scholarship. What we did was put all the names of the high school students in the basket. So Pastor will choose one. And the winner is, can I get a drum roll? Aaron Brown Jr. Okay, next what we're doing is putting all the college graduates in a basket. Drum roll, please. And the winner is Raymond Moore McCray. So what our circle did, this is a love gift from us to you in appreciation for all your hard work and how much we love you. Now to our graduates. First, I want to thank our graduation committee. Thank you all for praying. Thank you for your selfless work. And thank you just for being a part of each and every one of these graduates' lives. Graduates, you've been through some ups and downs throughout these years of education. Whether you have had challenges with your parents, your classmates, your teachers, or your professors. God did it.
He brought you to it and he brought you through it. Don't copy the behavior and customs of this world, but let God transform you into a new person by changing the way you think. Then you will learn to know God's will for you, which is good and pleasing and perfect. That's John 12:2. Follow your passion. Stay true to yourself. Never allow others to lead you astray. Remember, you don't receive respect, you earn it. You aren't given an opportunity, you have to fight for it. Remember to listen to that inner voice, which is the Holy Spirit. Remember that God brought you to it, and he'll bring you through it. Remember the power of prayer and all that it can do. Remember to take up your own mat and follow Jesus. Jesus said, "Ask me for anything in my name, and I'll do it." Pastor Davidson, Pulpit Associates, and Antioch family, I present to you the Antioch Baptist Church Class of 2019. Graduates, won't he do it?
That on Graduate Recognition Sunday, I get the opportunity to bear witness to our high school graduates who deliver the message on this wonderful day. Today is such an occasion that we have Malia Knuckles, Ethan Williams Taylor, Alexis Walter, and Richard White who will be delivering messages in their own way.
Amen.
We are grateful to God for them. And so now I'm going to call on Malia Knuckles, a 2019 graduate of the Cuyahoga Valley Christian Academy. Amen. Give God praise and glory.
For those of you who don't know me, although I'm sure that
I was asked to speak today about how God has influenced and impacted my life until this point. As tempted as I was to write out a long, cookie-cutter, good Christian answer, I realized it's more important to state how I truly feel. From the minute I was born, I've been a part of this church. I grew up in junior church, I'm in BYF, and you can catch me sitting in the balcony every Sunday I'm here. My grandma, shout out to Deacon Dolores Brown, has been a deacon here for 21 years, and I've gone to Christian schools for the last 13 years of my life that have taught me everything from having to memorize the Apostles' Creed in one night to learning about apologetics and how to defend my faith the next. While I am forever grateful for all of those things, none of them have been the biggest way I've personally seen God impact my life. I can genuinely say that He has shown Himself to me the most through experiences big and small. God saved my life when I was younger, but He has always placed phenomenal role models in my life to help me along the way. Looking back at conversations and advice they've given to me has helped me to make better decisions in situations where they had my best interest in mind more than I did. And I'm very thankful for them, because as hard as it is to believe, I'm not always perfect. Although the first instance may seem to have had a greater effect on me than the second, I've come to the realization that there are no small impacts when it comes to the circumstances God has placed and will continue to place in my life. They all play a major part in making me the person I am today and shaping the person I'll become in the future. While that being said, I'm proud to say that I'm 18 years old and have no idea what I'm doing with my life. I'll live, learn, and figure things out as I go, because first, only God knows what the future holds and is in complete control at all times.
Amen.
Second, I'm too young to spend the rest of my life stressing. And third, too much stress causes premature wrinkles and I refuse to have that. My point in all of this is to say I'm certain that God will continue to show Himself to me through my experiences, both good and bad. And maybe I won't notice that it's all for my benefit in the moment it's happening, but as I grow older, I know He'll bless me with a better understanding of why. Thank you.
Amen. Amen. Bless you, Leah. Next up, we'll have Ethan Williams Taylor, 2019 graduate of Villa Angela St. Joseph High School.
Part of this church, and I have so much support. I never would have thought that a church family would have so much support for
Next up, the Alexis Walter, 2019 graduate of Solon High School.
Girls, choir, dance ministry, I did it all. But all of that has helped me grow and really prepare for the future ahead of me. And I just want to say thank you, because every single person sitting in this room today, and those even who couldn't be here today, helped help me grow as a person. And I don't think that I would have been as prepared as I am today and for my future without Antioch and without God. Thank you.
Amen. Amen. And last on the list, they're in alphabetical order. This was not done intentionally, but I think it is appropriate, because the BYF led prayer a few weeks ago on the Wednesday night prayer service, and Richard made it clear that this was his graduating class. He made clear he's in my graduates. And so next up is 2019 graduate of Cleveland Heights High School, Brother Richard White.
Good morning. Oh, my fault. Graduation Sunday. A milestone day for all high school and college graduates as we plan to embark on our next journey of life. I stand before you all, honored to call Antioch my church home and blessed to have received such a great deal of love and fellowship through my lifetime. God plays a prominent role in my life, in and out of church, and the person in which I am shaping to become is his doing. God's role in my life is everything. Without him, I feel as if I would be lost, searching for answers and unsaved. His grace is unmatched, and spiritually, I am alive and well. He continues to remind me daily how much I appreciate him when he simply wakes me up in the morning. The best things in my life wouldn't have been what they are without his endless support and the blanket of love that came with it. From making friends throughout my school years, playing basketball, and working with kids now, I can easily say he has made life totally worth living, and for that, I consider his role to be the best thing going for me. Entering college, I know things will not be easy for me by any stretch of the imagination. I am excited to see how his role becomes even more meaningful than it already is as I grow. Through tough times, God has pulled me through. Sure, there have been some hard, grueling moments that changed me, like having to wash the dishes, or doing laundry, and maybe even the Cavs, Indians, or Browns losing a game. But as students, I'm sure there is a place we can all agree on where majority of our tough times were experienced: school. Most recently, college for a select few of us, but notably high school for me, was a roller coaster journey that I'm sure wouldn't have been completed without God. Endless prayers, countless talks. I found myself praying over an upcoming test, talking to him about an unfinished project, and ultimately thanking him for being there every step of the way as I walked the stage last month. When it comes to a shoulder to lean on, God's is undefeated, and he is the greatest resource anyone could have. Friendships are a large part of who you turn out to be, and the ones that God has placed for me thus far in my life are a blessing. I wouldn't be me without them. There were some trial errors along the way, though, as some bad friendships had to be cut short because the God in me saw a path they were on and told me to pump the brakes with this one. And I certainly listened. God's road doesn't end when I am outside the walls of this church. Rather, it grows immensely, which propels me as an individual to be the best me I can be, and I greatly appreciate that. Exodus chapter 20, verse 12. Honor your mother and your father, that your days may be long in the land that the Lord your God is giving you. Being raised by my parents has been the greatest gift from God, excluding life itself. I have learned an incredible amount of things from the both of them, and the way they have been involved and there for me is truly my greatest blessing. Wrapping up, God's role in my life is seen as the privilege of privileges, and I will never take it for granted. Thank you all so much for your love and support.
Come on, church family, you can do better than that. Amen. Give God praise and glory for Malia and Ethan and Alexis and Richard. Amen. Amen. Who wouldn't serve a God like that? Amen. Amen. As we prepare to offer an opportunity for those of you who have come today and may be looking for a relationship with the God that our graduates have just described to you, I offer this one story to those of you who will be going off to college or going off to do whatever it is that God is leading you to do. It's a story I've told before, but it is appropriate now. And it's a story about a little boy that got lost at a carnival. He got lost at a carnival, and he walked up, was walking around, he was looking lost, he started crying, he was frantic. And a kind older lady saw him crying, and she bent down and she asked him what was wrong. And so the little boy said, I lost my family, and I don't know how to get back to my house. I don't know how to get home. I know if I can get home, that somebody will be there waiting for me. And so she said, well, how would you describe? He said he felt like he lived nearby. She said, could you describe the journey to your house? Was there anything specific about the journey from your house to this carnival that you remember? He said, no. She said, well, are there any landmarks that you remember specifically that were near your house? And he said, yeah, I do remember one. There's a building across the street, and the building has a T on the top of it. It's a lowercase T, and it's way up in the air, and that lowercase T is right across the street from my house. And she said, oh, you mean, is it like a cross? And he said, yeah. He said, yeah, I think it is a cross. And he said, ma'am, if you can get me to the cross, then I can find my way back home. And so what I want to encourage all of you, that if you ever get lost, if you ever find yourself in trouble, you can always make your way back to the cross. And that's what growing up in church is really all about, is that you train up a child in the way that they should go so that when they are old, they always know that they can make their way to the cross. And it's at the cross that we are all able to see the light. If you would stand with me all over God's house, amen.